Good evening again. I'm Sophia Watson. I'm the Director of Adult and Technical Education, and I'd like to welcome you to the 2024 Wilton Simpson Technical College graduation ceremony. If you would please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Sorry. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Okay, for real, you can be seated. Sorry about that. I'd like to introduce our stage party this evening. School Board Vice Chairperson, Susan Duvall. School Board Member, Gus Guadagnino. Superintendent, Mr. John Stratton. Assistant Superintendent of Teaching and Learning, Mrs. Gina Michalicka. Assistant Superintendent of Business Services, Mr. Ray Pinder. Executive Director of Student Support Programs, Ms. Lisa Cropley. Executive Director of Business Services, Ms. Jill Brennahan. Executive Director of Support Operations, Mr. Stephen Crignally. Our special guest speaker this evening, President Emeritus from PHSC, Dr. Timothy Beard. Coordinator of Career and Technical Education, Dr. Radia Dent. Adult Literacy Specialist, Doris Tejada. And of course, we have lots of staff, former and current staff from Simpson Technical College. So if you guys can please stand up to be recognized by our students. Thank you everyone for being with us this evening. So on behalf of the entire faculty and staff, I want to extend my heartfelt congratulations to our graduates. As adult learners, you have faced unique challenges and responsibilities, and many of you have balanced the demands of work, family, and other commitments while pursuing your graduation. Your dedication, your perseverance, and your unwavering commitment to your education have brought you here, and you should be immensely proud. This achievement is not just a testament of your hard work, but also a shining example of the endless possibilities that come with lifelong learning. You've inspired all of us, and it's an honor to stand before you as the director of this incredible program. So, congratulations. And tonight, it is my honor to introduce our student speaker. Overcoming numerous challenges and demonstrating unwavering determination, this student has shown incredible resilience in earning their GED. Their journey is a testament to the power of perseverance and a belief that it's never too late to pursue one's dreams. Please join me in welcoming Giovanni Gutierrez to share his story with us this evening.
Good evening. My name is Giovanni Gutierrez. I would like to first start by saying congratulations to all the fellow graduates in the room, and thank you to our family and friends for coming here and supporting us. Growing up, I never really had anyone in my life to motivate me and guide me when it came to school and life choices. Only two people in my family were high school graduates, neither of which were my parents. This led me to ultimately making some poor decisions growing up, and I ended up dropping out of high school at 16 years old. Although I am not proud of my past choices, I have always maintained a steady income, so not having a high school diploma was out of sight, out of mind for me. I even opened up a business without one. However, it wasn't enough in today's economy. A couple years ago, when I lost my income, I was in the middle of trying to find new employment. Sure enough, they wanted a high school diploma, something I did not possess. This motivated me to go back and complete my GED to have a better future for myself and my family. The GED program seemed simple at first. Math class stumped me. I failed the test 2 times and I finally passed on my 3rd time. I was discouraged, but I was determined to never quit. I looked at my family every day and I knew I had to keep pushing for that green check mark no matter how long it took me. I knew I wasn't done there. I always had a dream of being an electrician, but I never had a push to go for it until now. After completing my GED last year, I immediately enrolled in a technical college to become an electrician. It was tough, ironically, a lot of math, which at first made me nervous as I strive to be the best student I can be. I am currently on president's list with straight A's in all classes, and I am nearing the end and looking so forward to that graduation day. I am here to say, no matter where you come from, no matter how many times you fail or lose sight of your goals, if you put your mind to it, you can succeed. I never imagined being up here to speak on my experience of getting a GED, but I am here, I made it, and I will continue to push for my dreams. Thank you.
Thank you, Giovanni. It's with great privilege that we welcome tonight's guest speaker, Dr. Timothy Beard. Dr. Beard's career spans over 4 decades, marked by his unwavering commitment to education and community service. From his early days as an instructional assistant to his tenure as dean and vice president at the University of South Alabama, and later as president of Pasco Hernando State College, Dr. Beard has exemplified leadership and innovation. His dedication to fostering academic excellence and inclusivity has shaped institutions and inspired countless individuals. So please join me in welcoming our guest speaker this evening, Dr. Timothy Beard, a true trailblazer and advocate for educational excellence.
Good afternoon. At PHSC, we would often say that this represents our finest hour. Thanks for inviting me to be part of your finest hour to this great and esteemed school board of Hernando County, Superintendent John Stratton, the adult education officers and staff, our distinguished guests, proud parents, beloved family and friends, and the remarkable graduates of this 2024 class. Can we give it up to them for another hand clap? We celebrate you today. It is an honor to stand before you as we celebrate this very significant milestone in your life. Your perseverance, dedication, and passion have brought you to this moment, and it is truly a remarkable achievement. This evening, I want to talk and share with you about winning. By the way, Mr. Giovanni, you are a winner indeed. Winning the game of life. And may I begin with a quote by the late, great University of Alabama Crimson Tide coach, the world-renowned Paul Bear Bryant. And I quote, "If you believe in yourself and have dedication and pride and never quit, you will be a winner. The price of victory is high, but so are the rewards," unquote. And please allow me to share with you another very familiar quote that was made by the great Vincent Lombardi, the late coach of the Green Bay Packers. He said that winning is not everything, it is the only thing. There are several principles, about 8. I recommend you follow in order to win this game that we call life. Rule number 1 is vision. To be a winner, you must have a vision for who you want to become. Consider these questions. What are the qualities of the kind of person you want to be? What are your dreams? What are your goals? What are your desires? And where do you want to go in life? The second rule of the game is set clear and empowering goals. Goals are essential for several reasons. They enhance your mental focus. When you set goals, you work with more urgency and purpose. They provide you with a sense of direction, guiding your life. Consequently, your mental focus is driven by the priorities you set to achieve those goals. Rule number three, believe in your ability to figure things out. Many people struggle with self-belief, but learn how to have faith in your total self and your ability to figure things out. Belief in yourself allows you to navigate unknown territory and say, and I quote, "I don't know what is going on here, but I will figure it out," unquote. Rule number four, have fun on this journey that we call life. When you have that vision, dream, and desire, you will enjoy the journey, even during difficult and stressful times. Whatever brings you fun, joy, zest, and enthusiasm, make it a priority. Rule number five, be patient but persistent. Life may not progress as quickly as you want it to. Be patient and give yourself the grace to do a good job. It might take longer than you expect, but be disciplined and focused on doing what is good for you and for others. With enough patience, success will come. Rule number six, life is tough, and we inevitably make mistakes, but learn from them. As you try new things in your life's journey, you will certainly make mistakes. Mistakes are a natural part of life and growth. However, those who don't win the game of life are those who don't learn from their mistakes. Life rewards those who learn from their errors and treat every experience as a lesson to move forward in a better way, to make a better you. And rule number seven, work smarter and harder than yesterday. Those who make progress in life do so by constantly learning, growing, and improving. They build upon momentum toward their goals by adopting and upgrading their efforts, skills, knowledge, and methods. They understand that to do better, they must get better, think faster, and work smarter than they did the day before. And lastly, rule number eight, expose yourself to new ideas, people, and places. We only grow and develop ourselves when we experience new things, when we learn something unique, and when we step outside the boundaries of our comfort zone. Expanding your horizons in this way provides you with a new perspective and opportunity for further growth and development. So, the graduates of 2024, I hope you will consider these few recommendations for your success as a step in achieving greater success in the future. I also hope that you will recognize that this is a time for being thankful for those who have helped you reach this milestone. I encourage each of you to always believe in yourself so you can reach that goal or goals and fulfill your dreams. And as I close this afternoon, I want to leave you with a quote from Ralph Waldo Emerson. And I quote, "Do not go where the path may lead. Go instead where there is no path and leave a trail." Congratulations to the class of 2024. As you embark upon the next chapter of your life, remember these principles and strive to win the game of life. For winning is not everything, it is the only thing. Congratulations, graduates.
Thank you, Dr. Beard. Those are great words. Thank you very much. Okay, at this time, speaking of PHSC, we have a special guest. Tonight, as you know, is a celebration of your hard work. And we have our partner from PHSC here this evening who'd like to recognize two of our students, two of our top students with a scholarship, and they don't know. So if you would please come up here, Mr. Krill from Pasco Hernando State College.
Good evening, everybody. So I am here to recognize two individuals for their academic excellence. These two individuals will be receiving what we call our top 10% scholarship. This scholarship is in the amount of $2,000 per academic year for 2 years. So on behalf of President Dr. Pizers, our Board of Trustees, and also our foundation, I would like to recognize these two individuals to come on up and receive your letter for your scholarship. Alexandra Novak. And Michael Broderick.
Mr. Krill, that's always the, one of the best parts of the evening, surprising students with scholarships. So we thank our partners at PHSC who make that possible. Another round of applause for our partners at PHSC and for our scholarship winners. Okay, we ready? Because this is the fun part. We're going to call Superintendent Stratton to the stage to certify our graduates. And then we're going to call your names to come and walk across the stage. How does that sound? All right.
Good evening, everybody.
Evening.
Thank you. This is absolutely one of my favorite events of every year, and it's pretty simply a reason why is because of you. Each of you comes here with a different story, whether you came straight out of high school to us or if you're returning after years of being out of school and coming back as an adult learner. You bring your own unique story to the table. But tonight, each of you also share something in common. And that's called perseverance. You've gotten through whatever obstacles, whatever adversity you've had to face, and here you are tonight. And I think Giovanni's story embodies and captures what I'm talking about, that I'm so proud of when I come to this event and watch each of you walk across this stage. So on behalf of the board, my staff, the staff of the school there at Wilton-Simpson Tech, we just wanted to say thank you. Thank you to you students. We're so proud of you. Be proud of yourselves. And also, parents, family, and friends, we want to take a moment and thank you as well. They're not alone here tonight. They're here with support. And thank you for that. Members of the school board, on behalf of the faculty, staff, and administration of Wilton-Simpson Technical College, it is my pleasure to certify that the graduates of the class of 2024 seated before you have satisfactorily completed all requirements of the law and standards for graduation as prescribed by the Florida State Board of Education, the Hernando County School Board, and Wilton-Simpson Technical College. It is therefore my recommendation that the certification be accepted and that the appropriate diploma or certification of completion be awarded. Congratulations to each of you graduates.
Mr. Stratton, Mrs. Watson, if you would please prepare to receive the graduates. Graduates, when your name is called, please walk across the stage to receive your diploma. At this time, I would like our IET program completers, These students completed an integrated program where they worked on their academic or English acquisition skills while completing their para-pro or nursing assistant programs. Please help me welcome Michael Broderick, CNA. Florence Celestine, CNA. Lilliam Diaz, CNA. Milagro R. Quintanilla, CNA. Dana D. Giuseppe, Parapro. Maria Escobar. Brooke Falcone, Parapro. Egla Rodriguez, Parapro. Efrain Rojas Jr., Parapro. Brittany Schaefer, Parapro. Maria Vasquez, Parapro. Rebecca Winder, Parapro. Stasia Young, Parapro. At this time, I would like to welcome to the stage our adult high school graduates. These students completed the credits and assessments necessary to attain their Florida high school diploma. Our adult high school graduates walking this evening are Reynaldo Alameda, Gabriela Diaz, Diabella Lema. Lewandowski. Michaela Morganelli. Harmony Mowry. Sana Nazario. Amarili Soto. At this time, I will be calling students who passed all four sections of the GED exam to earn their high school equivalency diploma. Our GED. Our GED graduates walking this evening are Jacob Botman. Brianne Betcher. Michael Broderick. Kaylee Ellis. Valami Evans. Alexis Fresconi. Giovanni Gutierrez. Olanda Hernandez Lopez. Brandon Jordan. Alexandra Novak. Destin Spivey. Turner. Gabriella Tyrell. Bridget Williams. I am proud to stand before our graduates who have committed so much time and energy to successfully completing their industry certifications. Our technical program graduates for this evening. Our technical program graduates walking this evening are Michael Black, Automotive. Zamira Huelvas, Cosmetology and National Technical Honor Society. George Fribley, Welding. Daryl Harvey, Cybersecurity. Christian Latin, HVAC, National Technical Honor Society. Jacob Larez Passmore, Welding. Lincoln Rice, Barbering. Manuel Rodriguez, Welding and National Technical Honor Society. Jaden Rogers, Cosmetology. Jason Sousto, HVAC. Solomon Schiller, HVAC. Joshua Self, HVAC. Tomas Sosa, HVAC, National Technical Honor Society. Lily Thomas, Cybersecurity. Justin Tracy, HVAC, National Technical Honor Society. Honor Saeed Urbina, HVAC, and National Technical Honor Society. Congratulations, graduates, on all your achievements. As graduates, you may now move your tassel to the other side. Class of 2024.
Just about.
Thank you. Please be seated for just a moment. In a minute, our graduates and stage party will rise and leave the theater. After our graduates have left the auditorium, we will have an area on stage for photo opportunities. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. Now, please stand and remain at your seats until the graduates have exited the auditorium. Congratulations.